Is Berklee worth it? How hard is it to get into Berklee? How are the dorms? And those are just some of the questions that we're going to be answering in today's video. My name's Ameer, and I'm a third semester student here at Berklee College of Music, and in this video, I'm going to be answering your spiciest questions as honestly as I can. But before we get into the video, two very important disclaimers. Number one, these are just my personal views. This is not a Berklee-endorsed video. They're not paying me to make this. They don't even know that I'm making this video. So my perspective may be limited, and I could be wrong, so please take everything that I say with a grain of salt. Number two, I want to be open and transparent with you guys. So right now, I'm fortunate to be on a huge scholarship right now, and I share this not to flex or to brag, but so that you can understand the context of my answers. Everybody's situation is going to be different, and so let's proceed with respect and sincerity as we try to answer the ultimate question, is it worth it? Question number one, how hard is it to get into Berklee?
Well, if you open the door,
so as of 2022, Berklee's acceptance rate is actually 52%, which is, to be honest, pretty high, if you ask me. In comparison, Juilliard's is 7.4% and Harvard's is 4%. So to be honest, in my opinion, it's not actually that difficult to get in as long as you demonstrate like a real drive and desire to grow as a musician. And the fact that you're watching this video says a lot about that.
But as for how much music theory you need to know to get in, let's ask my friend Rafi.
So how much music theory did you know before coming to Berklee?
Literally nothing. All I knew was third grade, like, whole note, half note, quarter note. Like, that's it.
So then you learned everything that you know about theory basically at school?
Yes.
Question number two, how are the dorms? Whenever Berklee talks about their on-campus housing, they always show this beautiful new modern 160 building, and don't get me wrong, it is really nice in there.
It was so nice.
But the thing is, this building is only 26% of their total housing capacity. You see, most of the rooms are shared, meaning that you're gonna be sharing a small room with one or two other people. And being a 22-year-old, the thought of rooming with a bunch of like 17, 18, 19-year-olds made my skin absolutely crawl. And so that's why I chose to live in my own apartment off campus. But if you wanna know more about the dorms, let's talk to some of my friends who have actually lived in them.
Where do y'all live?
I lived in 150.
270.
Tell me about that.
Rats, mice, rat droppings everywhere. I actually had my backpack eaten.
Really?
I had to get a new backpack, yeah. Like there was a hole in it and bruh. Yeah. Jerry just ate right
there. Jerry?
Yeah.
You named him Jerry?
I named him Jerry. There was also Remy.
Remy,
Tom,
yes,
yeah, there we go. Everywhere,
did
yeah.
Did he cook breakfast for you?
No, I cooked him.
I was actually placed first in 270, and then I heard all the stories and rumors about it, and I'm like, nah, I'm not gonna do it. I emailed the campus life saying, hey, I can't, all that stuff. Got placed in 150 in the triple, and I loved my experience there. Loved every second of it. I would even like stay for longer, but it's a bit expensive, so I just moved out.
It totally is cheaper to actually live off campus, but that's what we're all doing now. But I will say, for the vibes,
For the vibes.
At least for like the first semester, yeah. If you can.
So yeah, these are all things that we're gonna have to factor in for the question that we'll be answering at the very end.
Is it worth it?
Is it worth it?
Is it worth it?
So Amal and I are actually both international students, which leads us into our next question. How do you cope with knowing that you're not in your home country? Now for me, since I'm from Canada, coming here to the States wasn't actually that big of a shift, but I can't imagine like coming from Uzbekistan, what that must have been like for you.
It was a big cultural shift coming from the East, Middle East. I found my friends real fast. That was the main thing for me, to find a group of people that can help me in the beginning. Some Russian speaking friends, maybe in the same language, kind of the same culture. Keep in touch with your family, keep in touch with the roots and coming back once a year or something like that, if you can.
Yeah, absolutely. But I also find that because Berklee is such a diverse place, it's actually pretty easy to find people who perhaps share a same cultural background as you. So for example, I know that Eugene, who asked this question, is from Hong Kong, and like two of my best friends here at Berklee are from Hong Kong. So I think you can definitely find people to relate to. All right, so question number four, does Berklee provide opportunities to intern for musicians? So I was actually wanting to do this last semester. I wanted to do like a studio internship or even a content creation internship in New York. And so I went to the Career Center to ask a career advisor, and here's what they told me. Basically, Berklee doesn't hand out any opportunities like that. It's still up to you to do the research. It's still up to you to apply and do all that kind of stuff, but you can use Berklee's name, which is definitely worth something. But unfortunately, no, you need to go out and create the opportunities yourself. But hey, that's life, ain't it? All right, so our next question comes from TKNS7458. I'll be joining in September from South Africa. That is so awesome, and I will see you very, very soon. Are you able to get private lessons in a second instrument? So, yes, you can, and that's actually what I did last semester. So I signed up for a secondary voice PI or private instruction, but the thing that you gotta keep in mind when it comes to signing up for secondary lessons is that you're not able to do the usual 50-minute lessons. You're only allowed to do 30-minute lessons, and furthermore, on top of that, additional private instruction costs, last time I checked, $1,780, which if you divide that by the usual 15-week semester, you get $118 per lesson.
Oh my God!
Now on to our second last question before the big one. For the new people thinking of going to Berklee, what is your number one advice? Great question. So I've been thinking about this a lot lately, and depending on your circumstance, I think this could really be helpful for you. So here it is. Don't over-idealize Berklee into something that it's not. Everybody always says that Berklee is their dream school. In fact, that's literally what I posted like a few months ago. And don't get me wrong, there are so many fantastic, amazing things about this school. John Mayer went here, our Lord and Savior. Lizzie McAlpine went here. Quincy Jones went here. All these phenomenal artists went here. But the thing that I forgot to realize is that they also all left. But when I was first applying, I didn't think about any of those things. I was like, Berklee or bust. It needs to be this or it's nothing. And looking back, that was honestly a really huge mistake. I was so caught up in my emotions and my idealism that I failed to realize that a school is still just a school. You're still gonna have to do classes that you're not interested in. You're still gonna have to deal with professors who honestly are like pretty ass. I'm currently dealing with one. We don't name names, but you're still gonna have to deal with all of the normal things that you would get at a school. Now, don't get me wrong. As I mentioned, there are still many, many amazing things about the school, but as for being a dream, I would encourage you to ask yourself, how much of that dream is marketing? Which leads us to our last question, the ultimate challenge, the final boss. Is it worth it? Maybe. Let's break it down. So as of right now, August 2023, Berklee's annual tuition is $48,830. From what I found, their tuition increases at a rate of approximately 2.92% every year. So if we multiply that out by 4 years, we get approximately $200,000 in tuition costs alone. This doesn't account for books, fees, travel expenses, none of that. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that's a lot. So if you're gonna be taking on that much debt to attend Berklee, I would really caution against doing that. Starting your career off that much in debt is like a recipe for disaster. Okay, but what if you actually have a scholarship, or even better, actually just have that money, in which case, hi, can you please adopt me? I'll break it down into three if-then categories. If you're going to Berklee for the classes or for the education, then no. I went to a local music college before attending Berklee, and as I've mentioned before, the education really isn't that different. It's not that Berklee has some proprietary curriculum and music knowledge that the rest of the world doesn't know. Music theory is gonna be mostly the same wherever you go.
And that's what my friend Kyle thinks too.
Nobody should be coming here for the degree, because this music degree you can get anywhere in the world. Every competent music school will teach you the same stuff. It's about the community that's here. Mm-hmm. It's about the people. But if you're coming to Berklee because you wanna learn some advanced harmony, that's the wrong mentality to come here with.
I completely agree.
Now, if you're coming here for the degree, then it depends on which one. If you want to be a teacher, then maybe, but then again, you could always just get a music education degree from another institution, and in doing so, get a more comprehensive educational experience. But for the rest of us who simply want to be in the industry, I think it's common knowledge that here in North America, at least, you don't need a degree to be successful, as it's more contingent upon the work that you do and the connections that you have. However, there is a Berklee degree that I definitely do think is worth it, and that is the music business degree. Weird, right? So there are actually a whole bunch of other like degrees and programs underneath that, but I'll just use the umbrella term of music business. So I find that music business students at Berklee are the ones who actually get the ridiculously crazy opportunities. For example, when visiting artists come like Alan Stone or Donald Glover, the questions almost exclusively come from music business students. And when you combine Berklee's ridiculous industry connections with their business program, you get music industry business people who are set up from the jump. Lastly, if you're coming here to meet people, then maybe. Berklee is a talent magnet, and the people that you're gonna be rubbing shoulders with are gonna be the future of the music industry. I've personally met some of the most fantastic, amazing, phenomenal, extraordinary, I don't know how many other adjectives I can throw, just amazing artists that I have met, and I wouldn't have met them otherwise.
And that's been Rafi's experience too.
I've met so many people that I'm now working with, and I wouldn't be making the music that I'm making now if it weren't for them. So for me at least, I think it's completely worth it so far.
But we also live in the age of the internet. You can connect with anybody that you want to if you're making good stuff and you're putting it out there consistently. So I think that even the entire networking argument is starting to erode just a little bit. Now I'm gonna get real. As I mentioned at the start of this video, I'm fortunate to be on a huge, huge scholarship right now, and while I am grateful for it, it has also taught me that blessings still have costs. Something might be free on paper, but there are still hidden costs associated with that. Time costs being the big one, emotional, mental costs, and furthermore, opportunity costs. And I wish that I was aware of all of those before committing to a decision. So here's my take. If you want to grow as a musician but can't afford Berklee, then create your own curriculum. Find the best private teacher that you can in your local area, be a continuous learner, keep on making as much music as you can, put it out there on the internet, and see what happens. Because at the end of the day, if you really want to be a musician, then be one. And to help you out with that, I made this video right here where I share the 7 things that I wish I knew as a beginner.